Hey there, geographers, and welcome back to the Mr. Sinn channel. Today we're going to be going over five skills that you need to make sure you master in order to do well in your AP Human Geography class and also to do well on the AP Human Geography test at the end of the year. These skills are going to come up throughout all of the different units of the class, and every single concept you learn is going to connect to one of these skills. So they're really important. They're written in the framework of the course. So it's important that you have a good understanding of what they are so you can practice these skills as you learn all the different concepts in AP Human Geography. When students start taking Human Geography, a lot of times they struggle with understanding how to think like a geographer. Oftentimes they're still thinking like a historian. They're used to taking US history, world history, and they look at events in chronological order. Geographers don't do that. Geographers are looking at how people's activities are influenced by the Earth's surface, the relationships back and forth. Geographers are interested in looking at information spatially. Why would an event happen in one place but not another? And how do these places impact each other? We're looking at why systems are occurring, how they're happening. And the skills that we're going to be going over right now are going to help you better understand how to think like a geographer. Now, I will say throughout this video, I'm going to be referencing some models and different concepts that maybe you haven't learned yet, and that's okay. I'm going to be using them as examples so that way you can see these skills in action. All right, so the first skill you have to have is the ability to be able to break down different concepts and processes. Throughout this class, you'll be learning about different models and theories and complex systems, and it's important for you not to only just memorize them. In this class, you're going to be taking what's known as FRQs, and I'll get into FRQs in another video, but you're going to be asked on those FRQs to describe things, explain stuff, explain to the degree. These are task verbs. Again, I'll have another video on those if you need help understanding exactly how to take these tests. But these tests are going to be asking you questions to see, do you understand really these theories? Not just, can you describe it? For example, you're going to be learning about von Thunen's model in the agriculture unit, and you're also going to be learning about the concentric zone model in the urban geography unit. And there might be one that's like compare and contrast, where you're looking at the two. Well, I could look that, okay, both are using the bid-rent theory. This is a concept that as I move further away from the city, my land value is going to go down, things are cheaper, and then people will locate in different areas based off it. And agriculture, similar. Things are going to be occurring. Now, that's an oversimplification. This video is not here to teach you that. But there could be questions that are going to have you break that down and then apply it to maybe your local community, the country, or the globe. It depends what scale the question's asking. So this ability that you are going to develop to be able to take something complex and not only just understand what it means, but apply it to the real world is going to be key. So when learning about different concepts, always try to think about, okay, how does this work in the world that I live in? How does it work on different scales and levels from my own local area, maybe the regional area, the state, the country, the globe? This will help you refine this skill and make it so that you can do well on your test. The next skill you're going to want to hone is the ability to know spatial relationships. Geographers are always trying to better understand how different places and people and systems connect, how they impact each other, how they influence each other. And this is going to be important for you to do as you learn all these different concepts throughout the class. Why is it that a city might locate in place A but not place B? What situation and site factors are influencing that? Is it the geography? Is it rivers? Is it trade? Is it the culture? Is it the location of other cities? And once these cities are created, how do they interact with each other? How does the migration of people impact one place or another? How does local culture impact the broader country or even the world? These are questions that you want to make sure you're asking so you can have a holistic understanding of these concepts. And one thing you're going to do too in this class is you will look at historical events. But remember, we're taking human geography. You don't want to just memorize everything in chronological order. You want to understand how these events impact the world, how they impacted different regions. For example, you'll learn about colonialism and imperialism. Focus on how the diffusion of these cultures influenced different regions of the world, how it promoted a global culture, or the diffusion of English. So these are things you want to focus on. Less on memorizing the dates again, less on memorizing just basic names, and more on how these interactions between place A and place B change both of them. The third skill you're going to want to develop is the ability to analyze data. Now, this is going to be a really important skill because when you get good at it, you're going to be able to understand why the world is the way it is. And you're going to be looking at a lot of different types of data sets. You're going to look at population pyramids, different types of maps. You're going to look at census data, tables, and charts. And it's going to be important that not only can you read that data, but be able to apply it. For example, when looking at different types of maps, well, they're all showing data in different ways. What distortion might be at play? Is the data being skewed? Is it clear? What's actually being shown in the maps? When you get good at these skills, especially when looking at maps, you'll be able to start to see different trends. And I want to encourage you to think outside the box. Look at different data sets and then compare them, analyze them. Do they connect? Is there correlation? Now remember, correlation doesn't always mean causation, but maybe there's something we need to look more into there. When looking at population pyramids, for example, you'll be able to see into the future, into the past, into the current state of the society. Why is it that we might be seeing certain birth rates or death rates? What's going on within that community or within that country? These are all questions you want to ask. And when you get good at being able to analyze data, you will be able to understand so much more of the world you live in. The next skill that you're going to use is one that most students are more familiar with. It's the ability to analyze different sources. Throughout this class, you're going to have to be able to look at a lot of information, and you're going to have to be able to identify what type of information you're looking at. Is it a qualitative research? Is it quantitative? And is there bias in the information we're looking at? So we'll have to analyze and break down different sources. In this class, you're going to be looking at a lot of information, and some of it's controversial. And not only is it important for us to be able to break down the information we're looking at and understand is there bias in the source material, but also we have to look at ourselves. Are we holding certain biases in our own lives? Because when we're looking at all these different concepts, we're talking a lot of times about cultures all over the world that might have different values than us. And so we have to understand those topics through their perspective. And when we're looking at sources, it's important for us to take into account where it was written, who it was written by, and how did they present the data to us so we can make sure we have the most accurate representation of what information we're taking in. The last skill that you're going to be using in this class is one that most students struggle with. It's understanding scale of analysis. Scale of analysis is all about how information is being grouped together. Are we talking about the local scale? Are we talking about a regional scale, a national scale, or a global scale? When we change scale, we're changing the conversation. What's happening at a local level is different than what's happening at a national level or a global level. And you're going to have to be able to identify what scale is being used in different questions, in different data sets. And it's important to always look for that, because when we understand what scale we're talking about, then we can understand what context that the information being presented is in. Now, this is a trickier skill, so I am actually going to make an entire separate video that talks about just scale of analysis and how you can identify what scale of analysis is being used when looking at different types of data or questions. That way, this skill doesn't trip you up. All right, so those are the five main skills you're going to be using throughout the school year. Now, these skills aren't going to be on a test. You're not going to have to memorize them. The point of this video is to get these skills in the back of your mind. That way, when you're learning concepts throughout the year, you're able to practice them and make sure you're understanding everything. And when you get to your test, you'll be able to do well. And if you ever do need help learning some of the concepts, make sure to check out some of the videos on my YouTube channel. Consider subscribing, because I'm going to be posting videos throughout the year that'll help you understand all the concepts and make sure you're practicing these skills. Thanks so much for watching. My name is Mr. Sinn, and until next time, geographers, I'll see you online.